on behalf of CSDS and on behalf of Common Cause, I welcome you all for today's release of the report, which is Status of Policing in India, Police Adequacy and the Rule of Law in Practice.
This is for anybody who wants to understand the criminal justice system, how it works in practice in India, to see some basic data about things. So as Sanjayji said, the first report that we brought out was about citizens' trust and satisfaction in police, and the second one is about the working conditions of police. So and this, I must say that I am doing this presentation on behalf of many people. I mean, a lot of people who've worked extremely hard on this.
Until and unless we are removed from the control of the political system, we cannot deliver justice. Police reform, in the penultimate sense, would be an independent police. But that also raises a huge question, because though we all argue for the independence of institutions, how can a police force not be accountable? To whom will it be accountable? And is it a question worthy of study, of thought? I leave the question open to you.
1902, they said that radical police reforms are necessary in this country. And why are radical reforms necessary? Over the years, as politicians have become more unscrupulous and more unprincipled, what happens as a consequence is different. Earlier, it used to be just transferred from, what they say, a non-vegetarian posting to a vegetarian posting. Ek jagah paisa khane ki gunjaish hai, dusri jagah nahi khane ki gunjaish hai. But after that came a second stage. The second stage was that you will be punished. And now I think we are gradually moving towards a third stage, where you may be suspended, you may be arrested, you may be got arrested, you may be got involved in some case, you may have to resign, you may be jailed for something you have not done. So politicians are becoming increasingly more and more harsh for non-compliance of political directions.
Here is a person who has authority of law to inflict force on you, take away and curtail your personal liberty, investigate in a manner that can actually take away your life or liberty, and therefore you cannot go away with the excuse, oh, I come from the same pool of society. The phrase of institutional racism was actually coined by Lord Macpherson after the killing of a black man in England, transgender persons actually being facing perhaps one of the worst police violence ever. And I wonder whether we can justify that as political orders. So there is more to it, and we will have to reckon with that. The term institutional racism was defined as the collective failure of an organization to provide an appropriate and professional service to people because of their color, culture, or ethnic origin, which amount to discrimination through unwitting prejudice, ignorance, thoughtlessness, and stereotyping, which disadvantage minority ethnic people.
Point is, how do we make the system more civilized and rational? Do we have a system at all? If so, what is wrong with the system? All of us know the problem. Some of the problems have been highlighted by my predecessor speakers. Most of us know what's going on. The problems are, broadly speaking, I can simply conclude saying that lack of adequate training is one thing, as it was pointed out, and political influence. Yes, that sums up the whole thing. But then how in practice? Because the topic is Indian police and the rule of law in practice. It's one committed officer can make all the difference. But only thing is, who will put that officer? The normal course, the administration should have taken care of it. If this kind of a case is going on, administration should have taken care of it. Since somebody didn't take care of it, matter came to the court.
It's my unique pleasure to thank all our three panelists and the chair of the session, Prakash ji, Aruna ji, Vrinda ji, and Justice Chelameswar, for having provided us a range of ideas in the last 2 hours. I think the report was only a base, and from that base they raised a range of important issues. And I think everybody in this hall will go out with more questions than answers, and that I think was the objective of this particular report. So thank you all for having spent this evening with us and having contributed so richly to the discussion.